Morning, everyone. Hope everybody's doing great in Jesus today. And good morning again, I say, and hope your day is going to go well. This is the day the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Just want to jump on here this morning and wish you a great day in Jesus. And just want to kind of cover a couple slides that we did last week. And faith, hope, and love. But now faith, hope, and love abide these three, but the greatest of these is love. 1 Corinthians 13:13. And the Bible says, his banner over us, over me, is love. And just going to read a couple scriptures here to encourage you today. Amen. To follow Jesus. Amen. Let not your heart be troubled, Jesus said. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go prepare a place for you. That if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, you know, and the way you know. And let's go to, that was John 14:1-4. And we'll go to 14:6. We're going to skip down. I am the way, the truth, and the life. This is Jesus. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. And John 16:7 says, nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for me that I go, for you, it's expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter without will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you, that Comforter. One of the greatest deceptions today that we have is religious deception. Where else would the devil want to come but those that are getting close or wanting to find God? That's where he would have an intervention. That's where he would want to place his greatest power. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against power, principalities, spiritual wickedness in high places. He comes through man to deceive us. And that's one of the biggest deceptions, religion today, is that you cannot live for God without religion. That's what they'll tell you. You've got to be connected to a physical church or an organization. And while they try to manipulate that through scripture, it is not so. Jesus never said that. Amen. Gathering together does not have to be a church or a building. Sitting under a hierarchical corporate church structure under a priest or pastor is not a requirement for salvation. And many of you should think twice before you involve yourself in that, because it's, he said, they come as wolves in sheep's clothing. You know, your life in Christ, people will know that you serve Christ, Jesus Christ, by what you believe, by what you stand on. If you're promoting a church, a pastor, an organization, and if anyone's doing that, take note, because Jesus and salvation should be the one that you are promoting, not a church building, not a pastor, not an organization. That is a club that is called religion, and Jesus railed against religion. And if you'll read those Gospels and see what Jesus said, and you'll see in the first part of Acts when Jesus came back and then preached to them the kingdom of heaven. But anyhow, John 16:13-14 says, albeit when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and will show you things to come. Who? And 14 said, he shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you. And then 14:17 says, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you. This is Jesus talking to the disciples as he was there in the flesh with them. And he said, and shall be in you. And he went on to say, when you look at Matthew 24 and 4, when the apostles asked him, Lord, when is the end? What shall we look for? When is the end going to come? And what signs will there be when we know the end is near? And Jesus answered and said unto them, the first thing out of his mouth was, take heed that no man deceive you. And when you look at John 14 and 18, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Not man. Jesus did not say man would come to you. The law is abolished. And this is probably the most disturbing scriptures to priests and pastors today. Amen. They want you to follow after them. That is man. And they want you to be subservient to them. And that is what is taught and preached in religion today. But you being led by Jesus' Spirit and not them is disturbing to them. And the Antichrist is what that is. That spirit of Antichrist is to say, don't follow Jesus. Don't follow the Spirit of God. God can't talk to you. He's got to talk through man. But Jesus never taught that. Jesus never passed the baton. He commissioned the disciples to preach the gospel. What is the gospel? The connection to Jesus Christ, to God through Jesus. That is what we bring people to, Jesus, not man. Not to say, hey, come follow me. Jesus said, come follow me and I'll make you fishers of men. Fishers of men didn't say, bring them to yourself, but you bring them to me. And that is the big crux of religion today. That is the hierarchical structure, the corporate setting, and the system that they apply to and that they push on you. So when you look at that, you see, they hate grace and truth. Because grace and truth will take you to Jesus and will take you out of their control. It will take you away from their rule. But when you find God's Spirit, when you find that connection, the reason that God came down and made a body to take sin to the cross is to bring us back to that connection to Him without the veil, without the priest, without all these ordinances in place. Grace and truth came by Jesus Christ, and it removes their chance of deception, deceiving you. Take heed that no man deceive you. That's what Jesus' first thing he said to the apostles when they had asked, what are the signs of the end times? And when you leave religion and find Jesus, you will find happiness. You will find joy and peace in the Holy Ghost, because the kingdom of God is not meat or drink. Amen. I hope you have a great day today, and just in Jesus, ponder these things and let God be God. Amen.